To understand the book of Philemon, we need to know the main characters. First, there's Paul. Now, usually Paul would dictate his letters, but this one he wrote by hand because it needed to be verifiable and even serve as kind of a legal agreement with Philemon. Now, Philemon was a huge part of Paul's ministry. It was in Philemon's home where the Colossian church would meet. Which brings us to Onesimus. We know that he was once Philemon's servant. Onesimus was actually a very common Greek slave name, which meant useful. But that wasn't the case here. Before this letter was written, Onesimus had stolen from Philemon and fled to Rome. It was there that he heard Paul preaching the gospel and was radically saved and transformed and began serving in Paul's ministry there. So you can tell by Paul's letter that he grew to love him like a son. So this letter to Philemon is Paul's official sending Onesimus back to Philemon to help with the ministry there. In the letter, Paul asks him to now accept Onesimus as a brother, not a slave. And Paul offers to pay any debt Onesimus owes him. Now, what a beautiful story of the transforming power of the gospel. Onesimus went from being a slave to being free, from being a fugitive to being a son, from being useless to being useful, and from being a debtor to being fully pardoned. Paul explained it like this in verse 15. It seems you lost Onesimus for a little while so that you could have him back forever. He is no longer like a slave to you. He is more than a slave, for he is a beloved brother, especially to me. Now he will mean much more to you, both as a man and as a brother in the Lord.